over here, the two eyepieces, but of course, never forget, we want to cap the whole thing here, otherwise we're going to have some dust falling into the system. It is possible to adjust the distance of the two eyes by pulling or compressing this part over here. And the eyepieces also have something to pull out here. Now, why is this very convenient? People who do not use eyeglasses will probably want to extend the eyepieces in such a way that you have an optimum distance between the lens system and your eyes. So these are nothing more like distance holders, and they keep your eyes essentially away from the front lens, and this also keeps the front lens a little cleaner. Otherwise, there's going to be too much fat collecting on here. You gotta be careful. It is possible to very easily remove the eyepieces like this. Okay, so when you're moving the microscope or when you're transporting it, be aware that essentially they're not screwed into the system here, but are actually just loosely inserted. So the other one as well. Although this is always the danger that you fall out. Now, either one or both of them have a so-called diopter adjustment. This means this one, in this case the left one, I can rotate in and out. The other one I cannot do that. And this allows me to adjust in different, if my two eyes, if I'm short, for example, I'm short-sighted and one eye is worse than the other one, I'm able to actually adjust the differences in vision by turning the left one of the two eyepieces. But generally, if I use eyeglasses, then both of them should be set to the same adjustment. So, I think the last thing that we have to talk about is I just quickly want to show you how to exchange the lamp. And I think this should complete the basic introduction then. But let's first turn off the lights here again. And let's turn the microscope upside down to have a look at the lamp. I removed the eyepieces. I unplugged the microscope. And now we are having a look at the bottom of the microscope, at the base. And I'm just going to show you where you can find the lamp. Of course, every brand of microscope is different, but the lamp is hidden in here. I'm going to pull out this little button over here, and I can flip it down here, and you can see the lamp over here. Never ever touch it, because the fat of your fingers will burn into the glass, and it will also result in a lower light intensity, and it may actually also break the lamp. So you should never touch the lamp. These are standardized lamps that you can essentially exchange by just pulling it out and putting in a new one. And I'm just going to close the whole system again. Okay, this was it. And we can now turn the microscope right side up again.